Welcome back to Creative Loop TV. This is Andrea. Today in the loop, we have Denny the Saxmania. Denny Saxmania is a saxophone player that has captivated the attention of many with his music, like his private performances on Valentine's Day, covers on YouTube, and recently he got to grace the stage at the NAMA Awards. Hi Denny, welcome to In the Loop.
Okay, thank you for having me. How are you?
I'm fine, thanks. I'd firstly like to say thank you for putting aside time to come and talk to us. So the first question I have for you is, who is Denny?
Okay, Denny is an artist, a saxophonist specifically, a musician, an independent musician. Yeah, basically that's Denny.
Okay, and what is your full or what is your government name?
It's Denilson Musekiwa.
Oh, Denilson Musekiwa. Yeah. All right, so how did the journey start with you playing saxophone?
It actually started in 2018. But previously, I was a keyboardist, a guitarist before I started playing saxophone. Then I had to shift now, you know, being a guitarist actually and being a saxophonist is different. Frankly, saxophone is money in terms of making money. So then I had to shift because I wanted something that gives me money.
So how did you learn how to play saxophone? Did you go to school or are you a self-taught saxophone player?
Okay, I'm a self-taught saxophone player. I used YouTube to learn saxophone.
Really?
Yeah. Actually started learning in 2016. Mm-hmm. I didn't have the saxophone by then. The chance of YouTube, learning on tutorials, until I had to buy the saxophone in 2018. Then I applied all the skills.
So everything that you play now, like even the covers that you play, the notes, everything, because you know, like music has got so many things to learn. So you taught yourself everything.
Yeah, I taught myself. Actually, there's a relation by my instruments, like the keyboard and the guitar, the saxophone. So I opened it and I So it was easy. Guitar and saxophone.
Yeah, because the guitar is difficult.
Yeah.
So how much is a saxophone?
It depends. Tangira kuma 400, chipera kuma 5,000, depends with your budget. No, it depends with your budget and the sound that you're looking for.
Okay, so when you started playing saxophone, what was the first gig that you got?
The first gig, I remember the first gig. Okay, someone just contacted me on Facebook. Saying could see, actually I used to do my covers, did a kumba, just did them for fun. I never thought could just wait or marry or do gigs or, and then someone I can put up on Facebook, hey, hi, I love the cover that you're doing. Can you visit my house for a private dinner? And I was like, what? Private dinner? And I got to pakumba na tozo da and I got to
and biwa. And which year was this?
What?
Which year was this when you were?
It was 2020, end of 2018.
So it took you 2 years to learn?
Yeah, actually it was, I started playing in 2018, but learning was 2016.
Wow, okay. And so you went for the dinner?
Yeah, I went for the dinner. I just played what I used to play, did boomba and the love performance. Then from there, I started getting
it was just
gigs.
Automatic. Yeah. People just loved your...
Yeah, people just love.
I realized on Instagram this past Valentine's you had quite a lot of gigs, like you were delivering flowers, chocolates.
Yeah, that was hectic.
What does it take for one to, because it seems like that's what you get most, those are the gigs that you get most where you go and play privately. What does it take to get you to come and play?
Okay, amazingly, on Valentine's, mm-hmm. I just had about three gigs. But what happened, Panda and Akunoriza, when I started playing, everyone loved the performance. Shakuti, vanwaka poor pressure. You know, boyfriends, I feel like, I need this. Hey, doctor, boyfriend, young. Girlfriend, young, no sense, please, can you do this? Chichi. I ended up having more than 10.
Wow, so people would see you on the spot and say, please, go ahead and do this for me.
Yeah, vanwaka poor pressure on the spot. that's what happened.
And how much do you normally charge, like a rough figure of when you're doing these private gigs, how much do you charge?
Okay, on private gigs I do 100 per hour.
What? But
that's low, right?
Okay, depends. Okay, $100 for private gig. So then how much do you get for a proper, like I noticed you were at the NAMA Awards, like when you do like the actual gigs when you're on stage, how much then does that?
Yeah, actually it depends. Sometimes zvinzvine basa rakawanda zvinogona kutova the lowest paying, and zvine zvisina basa zvachona zvinogona kutova like a private gig. Something chekuti I don't even play too much, but I just might get my 100 per hour. But I can play at a wedding, a whole wedding, and still get maybe 150. But I was playing the whole. Yeah, it just depends with the market.
Also, yeah. with the gigs on stage, or like what you said at the wedding, is it because maybe you're part of a band when you go there?
Yeah. That's exactly.
Alright, how did it feel like performing at the NAMA?
It was actually an honor being at such a big stage. Yeah, I feel great. Watching all the faces. But yeah, I managed to play.
Have you since that time gotten more attention, you feel, since you played at the NAMA Awards, as compared to before you played?
Yeah, very, very much. And like, we're going to win right now. Do you remember now, right?
People you could recognize.
Yeah, and they say yes, and see Viro Barato Simba, see Viro Barawezera.
Alright, how many saxophone players? Because I know like when you are in the industry, you kind of know each other.
Yeah.
How many saxophone players are there like in Harare, for instance?
Actually, Takawanda, we are more than 100.
More than 100.
Yeah, but I wonder, but it's just that my fields are not Siana. There is Joseph, you know, really, on the gospel side. Mm-hmm. There is Vamana Silva, no Sis, JS side, Tarango Siana.
All right, I'm sure myself and many other people have always been under the impression that saxophone is not that popular in Zimbabwe, in Harare. Mm-hmm. But then seeing your videos, I've realized that, oh, there's actually like a market for it. There's actually lots of people that play that instrument. What is next for you? Do instrumentalists release albums?
Yeah, of course. I will be releasing an album this year. I'm not gonna say the name of the album because it's a surprise. Uh-huh. Yeah, I haven't released one before. I've been doing covers, quite easy. So yeah, we do albums.
Okay, and where do you see your brand Denny Saxmania going in the next 5 or 10 years? Where do you see yourself?
Okay, what should I say? I see myself representing Zimbabwe at an international level. Yeah, okay. Yeah, getting a BET award, a Grammy, something big.
Okay, that's...
Yeah, well recognized internationally.
So before we let you go, we would like to know, how old is Denny?
Old enough to play.
Old enough to play. And are you single or in a relationship, Taken?
I'm in a relationship. Okay.